to reduce targeted dislike attacks and their impact on creators, especially on small creators. You'll no longer see a public dislike count on YouTube starting today. The dislike button is staying. This comes after lots of research, testing, and consideration.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Cult Classic Kids Show, and I just really wanted to make a quick video discussing the changes on YouTube. In reality, I really do want to just talk about entertainment, but unfortunately, these changes do really affect me personally, and in a way, I'm actually being blamed for the current change that has taken place on YouTube, and that change is removing the dislike ratio that we see whenever you look at a video. Prior to this, removing the like-dislike ratio situation was an option. Now it's no longer an option. The dislike ratio is removed by YouTube, and I, as the creator, can see dislikes that people do give me, but nobody else can see them, and honestly, I do not like this at all. YouTube makes these really poor decisions, and they use people like me as a front in order to make them. This does not help the small creator at all. Most small creators get looked over as it is. I mean, whenever I get a dislike on my video, I love it. I mean, that just goes to show that I made someone really upset. And I want other people to know that I made someone else upset with my opinion. My opinion is a reasonable one, typically. I don't really have unreasonable opinions, I would like to think. But when someone gets upset about something that I say and they actually go out of their way to give me a dislike, I love it, and I want people to see it because I'm proud of it. You know who doesn't like all of these dislikes? In reality, those who don't like these dislikes are government, the people in power. When they say really crazy things that are irrational, but they have the power to get away with saying those things and enforcing those things, we as a society do have little means in order to express our distaste in our government. And one of those ways is by disliking the things that they say, by showing our disdain, our dislike. Another group of individuals who don't like dislikes, that don't like to be challenged, are corporations, large corporations. Like, for example, Nintendo, when they announced the Nintendo Online upgrade. That was disliked into oblivion and everyone saw it because, well, they made a really disgusting decision. And people didn't like it, and they expressed their dislike of that by giving the video a dislike. But giant corporations don't like that. They like to pretend everything is perfect. And if the people don't have a voice that's heard, well, most people's soured opinions just vanish. And that's what YouTube's trying to do, is trying to make our opinions disappear. They only want to see good opinions. When they see bad opinions, oh man, that's going to upset the governments that we're buddy-buddy with, the really rich and powerful people, the really rich and powerful corporation we're buddy-buddy with. That's all they care about, is appeasing the people in power already. This is simply just to secure the people at the top. And when you limit people's right to be able to speak out, to show their dislike of opinions and the power that's wielded by people who are so much more powerful than us all, or governments and corporations that are so much more powerful than us, regular people. Limiting people's rights to self-expression throughout all of history has shown to cause more violence. They think that, oh, well, if we drown out people's voices, that they'll just shut up and everything will eventually just disappear. All the dislike will disappear. No. When people can't express themselves, they get violent. And I don't advocate for any form of violence whatsoever. I'm actually trying to warn against it. So YouTube, stop using me, a small creator, as a scapegoat to basically pass these rules, change things up that limit regular people's right to speak up. Stop doing it. Because your actions create violence. And I don't want to see violence. So if YouTube, if you don't want to see violence either, stop doing these things that cause violence. Look back on history instead of trying to erase it. We know that you sold out on small creators and independent creators that built your entire platform in order to appeal to corporations. and the government, the people that used to downplay you and shun you, the companies that used to downplay you and shun you. Now you want them to be your friend. Well, now, guess what? Nobody's your friend. And I'm really sorry to have to make a video talking about this. I don't want to have to make these types of videos, but I'm disgusted that YouTube actually uses people like me as an excuse to do stupid things like this. I'm really just sick of it. Your decision to remove the dislike button only gives extreme speech, crazy things, more power to not be answered back against. Hiding the dislikes on YouTube only gives extremists more power. That's all it does. YouTube, honestly, I feel as though at times you really do just support extremist activity and help protect extremists. And honestly, YouTube, I'm calling you an extremist as well, because doing something like this only goes to show that you're just on the side of extremists, the people that don't want to be answered back, the people that can't take criticism from the general public. And honestly, YouTube, you are the same. So honestly, this is an extremist act. YouTube, I don't see you any differently from extremists. You are an extremist. Let me be very clear. The only people that like the concept of hiding the dislikes on a video are the ultra-powerful and rich, government, giant corporations, and also bootlickers. I completely oppose the concept of hiding my like/dislike ratio. I have no problem with one of my videos getting more dislikes than likes. That's absolutely fine by me. Stop using me, a small content creator, to remove the general public's voice. I'm not afraid of the general public. It sounds like YouTube's afraid of the general public. I really just feel like it was important for me as a small YouTuber, as a small content creator, to speak out about this and against this, because YouTube constantly uses people like me like a scapegoat, and I hate it, guys. I'm sorry. This was really off the cuff. I think you could tell by the quality of how I sound. I couldn't hold it in. I figured it was probably best to stay quiet, and who knows, I might actually delete this video. But I just needed to see something for now. Who knows if it'll still be here, but anyways, guys, until next time.